Hi guys, welcome back to the Weapons Import Program. This is episode 5, and now we're going to do something that is finally within my skill set, my skill range. This is a wheeled bot, an SMG cruiser by Cataphrat1. I've seen this guy very often. I think he's a fellow landship builder, if I'm not wrong. I've seen him around in the forums. He's quite old over there, I think. He's quite a veteran, so I'm expecting great things from you, pal. Anyway, the description reads, it is a moderately fast, well-rounded SMG cruiser. Stable during free falls, suitable for almost all roles for a ground bot. Yeah, I can sort of see that. Looks pretty well designed. Anyway, let's go on ahead and hire this thing. 2 million. Whew, better be worth it. Alright. So here we are. This thing looks moderately armored. Not just a... What was the description? It said something about... Yeah, it's not just moderately fast. It is also moderately armored, I would say. Look at how thin the hull is. I'm guessing, yeah, the pilot seat is over there. I think I can see some triforcing going on over there. Yeah. The wheels are exposed, but that should not be a big problem. Although it has only three pairs of wheels, so this thing might get immobilized pretty easily. So that's a hit to its durability. The wings here, the rudders here, are placed in a rather precarious position. The first thing that this bot is going to lose would be its rudders when the plasma globe hits. Yeah. Frontal armor is pretty good. There's some electro plates protecting some of the SMGs at least. So that should help out with its firepower, the sustainability of its firepower. Which isn't exactly lacking. How many guns is that? 12. Pretty good. Although I'm not sure how long it'll last. I mean, I could be wrong when I say the firepower could last a while. Yeah. This thing looks fast. It has a lot of thrusters. It looks faster than moderate, I'll say. But you never know. It looks highly maneuverable. Look at, it has a dedicated thrusters, left and right thrusters, so that might be something. Although I think the rudders might decrease the way how fast you could turn left and right. And then there's a problem with wheels. This thing could jump off cliffs, so I'm hoping I'll be able to put that to good use. This thing could do a very good ambush, I'll say. Yeah. Otherwise, it's looking pretty good. It's made entirely out of carbon 6 parts. Almost entirely out of carbon 6 parts. But I don't like the way the license plate are stuck like this. It's always constantly being blocked by the thrusters or by the guns. It's not placed correctly. Otherwise, it has the best of both worlds when it comes to aesthetics. It is both functionally beautiful and it is just as beautiful when it comes to pure beauty itself. I'm still worried about how this thing might just like get torn in half when it gets hit by a bomber or something though, but we'll see. Let's just test it out first. I'm interested to see how it handles. I mean, I've never built something similar to it at all. So the only thing I've built that is roughly similar to it is something with it's a, like a light tank with flight gear. It's a very old design, by the way. Oh man, didn't make the jump. Oh, that was close though. Moderately fast. That's pretty good, I'll say. Looks like a Batmobile. The guns are placed optimally, so it's gonna hit everything that comes its way. Although this is what I'm worried about. If it's firing forward like this, the guns are gonna hit themselves. I call it the misfire. So that's gonna reduce the DPS quite a bit. The most optimal firing position would be sideways, same like most tanks. Although the DPS is still slightly reduced, that's a problem. This thing might be better off as an AA bot. I'm gonna try jumping off the cliff right now. Let's see what happens. Oh, well, it sort of worked. I mean, if it's other vehicles, if it's other bots, it might just flip over. So that's a win, I'll say. Maybe it's too front heavy. I'm thinking a better way to make it more jump jet capable, more how do I put it? More jump capable, is there a term for it even? Is to put frontal thrusters so you can activate so it will land nicely when it jumps off a cliff. Otherwise, if the cliff is high enough, this thing is still going to flip over on its front. Otherwise, I have an idea. What if I stop accelerating when I get off the cliff? I could try that. Hey, that works even better. So, I guess it doesn't need upward thrusters all along. But I still believe that upward or even heck downward thrusters might be beneficial to this guy. So that it can keep going forward and still land nicely. One thing I'm not sure whether it's useful or not are the left and right thrusters at the back. I'm not sure whether they actually help with the turning. So you might want to look into that. Because if they are not helping, then they are a waste of CPU. And you could use the CPU for something else. You could just take those left and right thrusters off and do something else with the extra CPUs. Yeah. Alright. This being a cruiser is very easy to learn how to use. Even T1 players know how to use cruisers, I bet. So, this thing, when it comes to usability, goes without saying. The only challenge to its usability, I guess, would be how you have to learn how to fall off a cliff, that's all. Just don't accelerate when you're falling. That's pretty much it. Because if you accelerate, you're going to turn the vehicle faster. And then you land on its nose. Alright, let's take it for a team deathmatch. And we'll see how it does. Oh yeah, with mega bots, eh? Not a lot of flyers this time. So there's that. Although that might be a problem for this bot, because I can see this bot as a quick AA type of deal.
The battle for Ophiuchus Valley has begun.
Where are you going? There? Alright, I'm gonna try to flank the enemy. Wow, this guy is fast. Where are the... Oh, crap. Where are my teammates going? It's like... It's like they're slow, man. Took them a while to make a decision.
Plasma bomber spotted. SMG hover spotted.
Ha. Oh.
Mega bomb spotted.
Not bad. It took SMG fire pretty well.
SMG hover spotted. Plasma tank spotted. SMG walker spotted. Plasma bomber spotted.
Crap. Lost some wheels, but I'm still going. So I think the way the wheels are placed work pretty well for me as well. At least they are not placed on the same cube, so that's that. I'll say I did pretty well this match. I prevented the enemy from flanking by flanking them. Oh crap.
Railcopter spotted.
Hit me once. Where? I don't even know. So that's good. That means it could take real shots pretty well.
Plasma bomber spotted. SMG hover spotted.
I can go for another round, why not? Protect them. Can't move very well though, can't maneuver very well anymore.
Plasma hover spotted.
Wow! Still lost, but we did pretty well. Second place. Look at the amount of damage, man. So this thing could take some hits, yeah, I'll give it that. I didn't see whether it's Triforce or not though. So I'm not sure what contributed to its success in taking hits. But I did well. It did pretty well. 4 stars, why not? And its style, it's not perfect. By giving it 5 stars, it's to say it's perfect, but it's not. I can't say I'm a big fan of how the electro plates are put. And I can't say I'm a big fan of the nameplates. It does look like a Batmobile. the thrusters are fine. I guess. There you go. Alright. One thing I was worried about was how all these things might give it too little clearance, might give the Pegasus too little clearance. But so far it hasn't affected it much at all. Let's give it for another spin. I wonder how well does it, can it handle being in the front lines? I guess this time I'll follow the team. Oh, there's quite a few bombers and interceptors and... Oh, crap. A Tesla, gotta watch out for that. But this guy did a pretty good job flanking. I can see this, I can see flanking and stealth attacks as this bot's main role. Like the Batmobile.
The battle for Spitzer Dam has begun.
Alright, where are you guys going? Let me guess, the center. It's always the center, isn't it?
SMG Walker spotted. Medic Hover spotted. Medic Walker spotted. SMG Copter spotted.
Oh, this SMG thing's going Walker down. Spotted.
Medic Hover spotted.
It's not going anywhere now.
Plasma bomber spotted. Medic walker spotted. Medic hover spotted. Rail walker spotted.
Yeah.
Helicopter spotted.
Well, no one was like, it's like no one was firing on this guy. So I can't accurately test him.
Plasma bomber spotted. Medic hover spotted. Plasma bomber spotted. Medic walker spotted. Tesla flyer spotted. SMG tank spotted. SMG copter spotted. Plasma bomber spotted. Plasma bomber spotted. SMG tank spotted.
Holy shit, this guy is really good as an anti-air, just as I predicted. They can't stand out against it. And with his speed, no aircraft is gonna escape, ever.
Plasma bomber spotted.
It's like this thing is loaded with aircraft engines. Yeah, there's plenty of triforcing, alright. Wow, third place. So far I'm amazed. But then I wonder what happened if we put it through the grinder. That is to say, the battle arena. So it's the triforcing that benefited the Pegasus. Improve its damage, resistance. Sorry, I can't speak. I'm eating some lozenge. Fisherman's friend. Another thing I noticed about the Pegasus is that its profile is rather low. The way it's designed, the way it's so slick and short, makes it harder to hit, especially when you're on uneven terrain. That should help a bit. Haven't received a full plasma blast in the face though, so I can't tell if it can You can suffer such damage and still continue pushing. So, well, we'll see. Plenty of opportunity for that in the battle arena, alright? If the game would start. Anyway, let's talk about something else. How have your day been? My days has been quite terrible, actually, these past few days. It's like, yesterday, coming home from work, my wallet fell out of my back pocket. And I was on the train, so I had to go back and take it. And by that time, it was rather late, so I decided to take a taxi. And I figured, hey, it's the best moment to try out Uber, you know, the service. And I knew nothing about it. Well, so I signed up for it, and it looks okay. I mean, in the beginning, I saw that there were surcharges, and I knew immediately what it meant. That was like 3.5 when I logged in. So I waited until it's 2.6. I figured, hey, I mean, the Uber charges weren't that high, maybe $10 or $15. So I figured times 2.6, not that bad. I mean, first time, why not, right? Learn everything I know about Uber. And when I got to my house, it was $71. Yeah. Everything I heard about Uber being cheaper is all wrong, in Singapore at least. It costs something like, so you do the math, 71 divided by 2.6, imagine that. It's just like any other taxi, you know, it's just like any other taxi companies, you know, just as expensive. The only difference is that Uber, with Uber the taxi comes to you, and you don't wait for the taxi, that's it. I suppose it was just it's just me and my bad luck, I suppose. My workplace was further than I thought. You know, I thought that with the expressway it would be really fast. The charges, as I discovered, kind of like took into account the time and distance of the trip. This thing is taking forever. I'm going to start all over. So there you have it. That was yesterday. And about today. Yeah. A maintenance man was supposed to come. And he didn't. And when I opened the door, I noticed a note stating that he tried the door when he tried the bell at 2:43, but my doorbell was broken. And so he left, and I have to reschedule again. This will be the second time, I think. And that resulted in me being late for my fitness test at a nearby army camp. And that would have been fine, because at least I could still take it. I was just late, so I was pushed to a slightly later timing. But then again, that resulted in bad weather, because there's bad weather and I have to wait for 1 or 2 hours for my final station, the 2.4 km run. Had I been in an earlier batch, I would have cleared the fitness test very quickly, and I came back home late again, just like yesterday. Alright, now what have we got? Two bombers, one Tesla. There's always one Tesla. Alright, I can handle this. Let's go.
The battle for Ophiuchus Valley has begun.
One thing I noticed is that this bot's turning arc is rather small. So my guess is that the rudder really did a number on its maneuverability. Oh, that was fast.
Your fusion shield is now active.
Alright, let's see if I can ambush them here.
The middle fusion tower has been captured. Plasma bomber spotted.
Surprisingly, the wheel bugs aren't affecting this bot, so that's good.
Tesla flyer spotted. Medic hover spotted. SMG walker spotted. Plasma bomber spotted. SMG hover spotted. The top fusion tower has been captured. Tesla flyer spotted.
Whoa, that thing, that copter is really, really tough. Oh crap. Oh. Yeah, I lost one side. All my wheels on one side. Not as durable as I hope it would be. Medic.
You have captured the enemy's middle fusion tower.
Medic. I still have 4 guns, that's not bad.
SMG walker spotted. Your middle fusion tower is under attack.
It did okay, I guess. Took quite a number of hits. If only the medics were better.
You have captured the enemy's top.
Alright, let's go.
Your enemy's fusion shield has been deactivated. Your middle fusion tower is under attack.
Shoot.
Plasma copter spotted. Tesla flyer spotted. SMG walker spotted. SMG walker spotted. Your middle fusion tower is under attack. Medic hover spotted. Medic cruiser spotted. Your middle fusion tower is under attack. SMG walker spotted. Medic hover spotted. SMG walker spotted. Your middle fusion tower is under attack.
Wow, those cliff jumping are really helpful.
Fusion tower is under attack. Your middle fusion tower is
under attack.
Your middle fusion tower has been captured. Plasma bomber spotted. SMG walker spotted. Tesla flyer spotted.
Oh crap. I was too late. Oh man. Oh. Oh god. Right into the heart of the enemy territory. Oh man.
Medic cruiser spotted. Your top fusion tower is under attack.
Alright, time to do some anti-air duties.
Plasma bomber spotted.
Good thing about it is,
top fusion tower is under attack.
About its speed is that it could really rush to defend the towers SMG if needed.
SMG walker spotted. Medic cruiser spotted. Plasma copter spotted. Medic cruiser spotted. Plasma bomber spotted. Plasma copter spotted.
Oh crap, I can't do this alone.
Your top fusion tower is under attack. Your bottom fusion tower is under attack. SMG walker spotted. Medic cruiser spotted. Plasma bomber spotted. Your bottom fusion tower is under attack. plasma copter spotted.
Oh crap, I'm off here.
Your bottom fusion tower is under attack. Medic hover spotted. Plasma bomber spotted. SMG walker spotted. Your bottom fusion tower is under attack.
This thing.
Medic hover spotted. Your bottom fusion tower is under attack. Plasma copter spotted. Your bottom fusion tower is under attack.
I'm always alone here.
Plasma copter spotted. SMG hover spotted. SMG walker spotted.
Probably give up territory.
Plasma bomber spotted. Your top fusion tower is under attack. Medic cruiser spotted. Plasma copter spotted. Tesla flyer spotted. Medic hover spotted. SMG walker spotted.
Haha, can't take it anymore, can you?
Tesla flyer spotted.
Finally.
Plasma copter spotted. Medic cruiser spotted.
Wow, this thing takes a beating.
Plasma bomber spotted. Medic hover spotted. SMG hover spotted. You have captured the enemy's middle fusion tower. Your enemy's fusion shield has been deactivated. Your middle fusion tower is under attack. Plasma copter spotted. SMG walker spotted. Medic hover spotted. Medic cruiser spotted. SMG hover spotted. SMG walker spotted. Tesla flyer spotted. SMG walker spotted. Medic cruiser spotted. Medic hover spotted. SMG hover spotted. Tesla flyer spotted. Plasma copter spotted.
Oh crap. Oh no. But at least I didn't die instantaneously. Boy, the Pegasus makes a good tank. Even, I'll say.
Your top fusion tower is under attack. Plasma bomber spotted. SMG walker spotted. Your middle fusion tower is under attack.
The enemy is strong though.
Your middle fusion tower.
It could resist a siege very well.
Plasma copter spotted. Your middle fusion tower is under attack. Your middle fusion tower has been captured. SMG walker spotted.
I wonder if we can go up a cliff, this thing. Almost there. Not bad. It can barely SMG do that, but that's good enough for me.
Medic hover spotted. SMG hover spotted.
Wow, the thrusters have dropped a lot.
SMG walker spotted. Plasma bomber.
Come on, let's go. I wonder how fast will we be on overclock 13. Charge.
Your top fusion tower is under attack. Plasma copter spotted. Plasma bomber spotted. Tesla flyer spotted. You have captured the enemy's middle fusion tower. Your enemy's fusion shield has been deactivated.
Come on, hold on to that tower.
Plasma bomber spotted. Medic cruiser spotted. Your top fusion tower is under attack. SMG hover spotted. SMG walker spotted. Your top fusion tower is under attack. Tesla flyer spotted. Your top fusion
Come
tower
on.
Is under attack.
I'm bugging out of here when they take the tower. No excuses.
Plasma bomber spotted. Your top
oh crap.
Tower
I'm out of here, man. I'm out of here.
Medic hover spotted. SMG hover spotted.
That guy, I think he bugged out or something. Oh no.
SMG walker spotted.
Die, you.
Plasma copter.
Ooh, I'm off here. Oh crap. Ouch.
Your middle
Help me.
Is under
oh, oh. Oh man, that was brutal. Oh. Yeah. That was why I was afraid of. You get bombarded. Yeah, this thing. Couldn't handle it pretty well. Great, they're taking back the power again.
Your middle fusion tower has been captured. Medic hover spotted. Plasma copter spotted. Medic cruiser spotted.
Who spotted me?
Tesla flyer spotted. SMG hover spotted. SMG walker spotted. Medic hover spotted. Plasma copter spotted. Your top fusion tower is under attack. Tesla flyer spotted. Your top fusion tower is under attack. You have captured the enemy's middle fusion tower. Your enemy's fusion shield has been deactivated. Medic cruiser spotted. Medic hover spotted. SMG walker spotted. SMG walker spotted. SMG walker spotted. Your top fusion tower is under attack.
SMG oh crap. Oh. Man, but I lasted quite a while there.
Plasma bomber spotted.
Silver, huh? All those medics. Oh my god, three
SMG
of them.
Your middle fusion tower is under attack.
But we are sieging them really good. I just wish my teammates would, I don't know, start migrating over there a bit.
Your middle fusion tower is under attack. Plasma bomber spotted. Your middle fusion tower is under attack. Your middle fusion tower has been captured.
Oh my god, what are you doing?
Medic hover spotted. Medic cruiser spotted. Tesla flyer spotted. SMG walker spotted. Plasma copter spotted. Medic hover spotted.
Oh man, I think that guy needs help.
Your bottom fusion tower is under attack. Plasma bomber spotted. Plasma copter spotted.
Alright, going back. Whoa, I. Oh, whoa, 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 oh, oh. Oh, crap.
Tesla flyer spotted.
Oh, man.
Plasma copter spotted.
Oh, man. Awesome driving ex Brian Nova. But at least this thing recovered pretty well.
SMG Walker spotted. SMG Hover spotted.
Wow, this thing is like the fighter jet of the ground. Look at how fast it's going. I wonder how fast you go at OC-13.
Your top fusion tower is under attack. Medic cruiser spotted. Plasma bomber spotted. Tesla flyer spotted. SMG walker spotted. Plasma bomber spotted. Plasma copter spotted.
Look at the number of rotors this guy has, man.
Medic hover spotted.
I'm off here.
SMG Walker spotted. SMG Walker spotted. Plasma copter spotted. Your bottom fusion tower is under attack. Your top fusion tower is under attack. Your top fusion tower is under attack. SMG Walker spotted. Your top fusion tower has been captured. You no longer have your clock cycle booster. Plasma bomber spotted. Clock cycle booster activated. Tesla flyer spotted. SMG walker spotted.
Can I really focus more on AA more? Those guys can't handle it.
Your middle fusion tower is under attack.
Oh, really? I'm doing that bad.
Your middle fusion tower is under attack. You have captured the enemy's top fusion tower. Your enemy's fusion shield has been deactivated.
Shit.
SMG Walker spotted. Your middle fusion tower has been captured.
Oh, I'm the last level troll. Am I? I can't see the first number. Sneaky.
Plasma copter spotted. Tesla flyer spotted. Your top fusion tower.
Oh man, he's so past me. Oh man, I thought they wouldn't notice me.
Your top fusion tower is under attack. Plasma copter spotted. Your top fusion tower.
Oh great. Why are we losing?
You no longer have your clock cycle booster. SMG Walker spotted. Your plutonium reactor is under
Come
attack.
On, capture a tower or something.
Your plutonium
oh, man.
Reactor is under attack. Your plutonium reactor is under attack. SMG hover spotted. Your plutonium crystal is nearly destroyed.
What is this guy doing?
The plutonium reactor is under attack. SMG walker spotted. You have captured the enemy's
Oh my god, man. How are you doing?
Activated. Plasma copter spotted. Your plutonium reactor is under attack. Your bottom fusion tower is under attack. Your bottom fusion tower has been captured.
Jeez.
You no longer have your clock cycle booster.
Some people.
Medic hover spotted.
Come on, charge.
Crystal is nearly destroyed.
If there's one thing this thing is good for, it's charging. Oh no! Oh! Well, we didn't do very hot. Second last. Oh man. Oh, how did it come to that? I thought this bot was doing very well. I guess it's just the team balance. And me hiding in a corner. Okay, so I've taken this guy out for a very long spin. Oh no, not my star. Okay, oh, it's still there. Alright. So what I figure out is it can take some damage, although a good shot right in the middle would tear in half. I guess that has a lot to do with it being light. In the end, it's a light cruiser. Light or medium, I can't tell, but around there. I'll say 300 to 400 cubes, maybe. 500 tops. So, this thing doesn't have the armor to sustain much damage, but whatever it can sustain is good enough, provided you have medics. It did pretty well defending that tower anyway, so that's that. Overall pretty good. The thrusters at the back might need shaving. The wheels came off rather easily once. The problem with the wheels is that they can be easily targeted. Skirts might have helped, although at the cost of some maneuverability. Speaking of maneuverability, it's mostly okay. The turn arc was quite large though. You have to make a huge circle before you can go around. Do 180. But so far it's not that bad. I didn't have to do a 3-point turn, so that's okay, I guess. Any new insights? The number of guns is more than enough. Even when it's nearly dead, it still possesses 4 guns. So the way the guns are distributed, the number of guns, how they are protected. Yeah, it's all good. Firepower wise, this thing has plenty. So it's probably going to get a very high attack, I mean a firepower rating. I'm not sure whether these two plates right here are of any use. What's the point of putting those there? I don't get. So maybe you could move those elsewhere. Maybe at the front, provide more coverage, or even at the side. Yep, overall it provides a very good experience. So that's all. Let's move on to the graph, shall we? And there we go. This is the performance of the Cataphrat1's GKLS. I almost said JK Rowling. GKLS Pegasus. This thing is the best robot so far I've reviewed. It is an all-rounder and a pretty good all-rounder. Its only weakness being its durability, which we'll talk about. This thing could take a fair amount of beating, although not too much. It will still get ripped in half by a full volley of plasma from the top. Although I'm still wondering whether I was just being unlucky or not. I think what contributed to this guy's not so bad, okay kind of durability is the triforcing. Would be, I think the electroplating helped a bit, although there's a few redundancies at the back. The number of guns probably helped a bit as well. I mean, those I think still shoot the robot a bit. The reason why I I didn't give it any durability higher, any durability rating higher, is because the wheels are exposed. Some of the guns are mounted in steels. It's unavoidable, yes, but I know a few ways in which you could avoid that. But that would change the very nature of the bot itself. Might not even be able to jump off a cliff the way it could. So yeah. What else? It is flat, so that could be the reason why a volume of plasma could rip it in half. So that contributed to its lower durability rating. I feel that space armor would help this bot a lot. I tend to build my tanks and cruisers with space inside, so that damage is distributed around it, and that would mean that it wouldn't get ripped in half immediately. So yeah, that could be a solution for this bot. But that would fundamentally change the bot, turn it into a kind of a kind of tank or a wheeled tank, or yeah. So you might want to think about that. The rudders were rather vulnerable. The wheels were vulnerable. The pilot seat, I think it's vulnerable as well. I mean, the way it's exposed like that, so that's that too. That's why you get a B for durability. Now let's move on. Firepower goes without saying. This thing has 12 guns. Even when this thing has been quartered, like even like with 20% of its health remaining, I still saw 4 or 5 guns on it. So firepower wise, this thing is covered. The only reason why I didn't give it a higher rating is because sometimes the guns would hit each other at certain angles, and that reduces the DPS. The relative fragility of the bot reduced the firepower rating as well. The firepower is still sustainable though, so it didn't the poor durability didn't reduce it as much, or rather the having 5 for durability is pretty good enough to maintain its firepower as observed in a practical setting. What else? With SMG, this thing is versatile, so I can't penalize it based on weapon type, although I'm not sure if I do penalize, whether it's grounds for penalizing a bot weapon type. I think it is. I mean, in the end, your choice of weaponry does affect the... Yeah, I mean, it's your choice what weaponry you use. Yep, so that's for firepower. As for speed, this thing has thrusters, it has 6 wheels. Goes without saying, this thing is fast even at overclock level 1. Going at 110, 120 miles per hour, and this thing is basically a jet fighter on land. This thing could zip across the map in a matter of seconds, in what, like half a minute to 45, maybe within a minute. This thing could definitely less than a minute. This thing could race across the map very well. Yeah, this thing is good for flanking, and which makes it good for a lot of tactics that you can deploy using this thing. I didn't give it higher because it is... I was almost going to give it a triple A rating, but considering its durability and how fragile it is, yeah, I reduce it to a double A, because in the end, there was this once all of the wheels on one side of the bot got destroyed. If it weren't for a medic, it wouldn't have moved at all. So that's that, yeah. Also taking into account that the wheels are still a bit hard to reach, so its speed is pretty good, pretty sustainable, so that's why I gave it a 7. Okay, as for maneuverability, it received a 7 as well because of the amazing cliff jumping ability that Cataphrat1 gave it using the rudders, although it's not something that lasts, so I didn't give it any higher rating. I reduced the rating to double A also because the way it turns is a bit poor. Like the circle it has to make might be due to a rudder, could be, I don't know, the turning trusses at the back I feel didn't really help much, although I'm not sure whether it helps or not. I mean the arc was really big. With other vehicles it would have, I mean other wheeled cruisers would have almost be able to turn on the spot, but in the case of this bot, no, not so much. I could be wrong though, you guys could comment on that if you want. Maybe I could have moved slower to turn on the spot, I don't know. But bottom line is this thing is more maneuverable than it's not. Being able to go where other wheeled bots would have had trouble. It could climb over a hill for crying out loud, so this thing's pretty good. Yeah, when it comes to maneuverability. Moving on, tactics. I'm not quite sure what this thing is built for. It wasn't stated in the description. But that was a sign, I believe, telling me that this bot is highly versatile, and it shows. It is good for it's good to perform AA functions, anti-air functions. It could rip aircrafts to shreds. It could flank because of its speed. It could do a surprise attack because of its speed. It could backstab because of its speed. And yet it could hold its own pretty well with a durability of B. I think cruisers and tanks tend to be able to do that, and this thing does that. I mean this thing was able to do that. Yeah, it is at least able to do that for a while. So yeah, this thing is versatile. The only problem is that it doesn't have a defined role, shall I say that. It is a jack of all trades, but it is a master of none. This thing isn't designed for any specific purposes. So yeah, that's why it doesn't receive a rating of any higher. I'm not sure. It's like it won't be able to perform any role perfectly, shall I say that. Like it cannot bombard enemies the way a bomber could. It is slower than bots that are truly designed to flank. Although that's not necessarily a bad thing because it has extra armor. But yeah, slower. It is not designed to hold its ground to hold the battle line, because its armor is limited. So there you go. The only limitation to its tactics, unfortunately, is lack of a defined role. So there you go. Although having a defined role is still make it take a hit on the tactics. That's how it is with my rating. You can never build the perfect bot. It's like you can't have a bot with a perfect rating for everything. That's the beauty of my system. Yeah, moving on. Before I rant even more to its usability, it's I rated this as 9 special because I mean it's a wheeled bot. We play the game at the beginning with a wheeled bot. We start our Robocraft life with wheeled bots. Anyone knows how to use a wheeled bot, so that makes this vehicle extremely accessible. The only thing stopping this bot from getting a perfect rating for usability was its cliff jumping ability. Some players might not notice it, they might take a while to learn it. If it weren't for my experience, I would have taken a while before realizing how to do a perfect cliff jump. That's about it really. If players weren't informed by it, they'll probably never know about its cliff jumping ability. Yeah, so that's about it for usability. It's extremely usable. It is extremely intuitive to use. it is versatile, so you can use it any way you want it. So you don't have to learn much in the end. It's all up to pure skill on the part of the player if they want to excel. That's it. But it has nothing to do with perfecting their skills with the vehicle. It's all about perfecting their skills with Robocraft. So it's extremely usable. And lastly, aesthetics. This bot functions well and yet it looks good. I guess some people do have it all after all. That kind of extends to bots, I guess. This thing looks good and it's only held back by how poorly the nameplates were positioned. The nameplates were positioned wrongly. It looks a bit messy, but it has its own beauty. It might not work for some people though. It's made entirely out of carbon 6 cubes. I mean, you can't beat that, right? Although it would be great if you explore ways to use normal cubes. Like what Frowning Lizard did back in the previous episode. He didn't use any carbon 6 cubes and yet he was able to build something beautiful. So you might want to explore that. Although it's not a must. I mean, we all build things our own way, so yeah, that's all I guess. Let's move on, shall we? Good bot, by the way. So there you have it. This bot is no doubt one of the better bots, one of the best bots I have reviewed, and might still be the best bot I will ever review. I mean, it got an A- in terms of overall. I kind of didn't mention that in the graph, but there you go. A 7 or A-. Yeah, awesome, congrats. I'll no doubt be playing this even after I'm done with this episode. Actually, I've been doing that with this guy, the Electro Falcon. He's fun to use. But yeah, good job. Keep building, keep excelling. The weapons import program will continue, and I'm hoping I'll be able to find more bots like this. Although so-called weak or poorly built bots, I welcome also, because I mean it's all about the effort, it's all about the players, it's all about building for fun. So don't let poor ratings stop you. I mean, I know I've built lousy bots before, and it doesn't stop me. It's all in the name of fun. I mean, it's a game after all, right? Anyway, one last thing I want to mention is, I'm not sure if I'm doing it, but I might be favoring ground bots a bit. I'm hoping I'm not, but I might be. Although there's something to be said about ground bots. I mean, they were the originals. They've been in Robocraft ever since the beginning. There's a reason why they do well. And being ground bots, they could take advantage of terrains and all these things. So I'd like to think that I'm not biased. There's certain merits inherent in using ground bots. So yeah. I hope that I'm not biased. I'd like to think I'm not. I pride myself in being an objective person. So that's the only other thing I'd like to mention. Otherwise, thanks for watching. Thanks for watching episode 5. Do subscribe if you haven't subscribed. Do like the video and do comment as well. I'm sure you guys have a lot to say about this bot. I mean, look at it, awesome, right? And I'll see you guys next time. See ya.